This week's Total Lunar Eclipse will give us a fantastic 1 hour and 22 minutes of totality to shoot the blood moon. The eclipse will occur on Sunday, September 7th. And this is how to photograph it step by step. To shoot the eclipse, the first thing you need to do is to plan your shot. This is to figure out the shooting spot and the shooting time the photo of the clip you want to capture occurs. For instance, this is our PhotoPills meetup plan for the eclipse. On September 7, 2025 at 8:15 PM, we're gonna be at the red beam position here in Menorca, photographing the blood moon behind the Favaric lighthouse. Hey, this beautiful lighthouse that we love in Menorca. And the blood moon will be right behind the lighthouse, which is pretty cool. Actually, if you go to panel number 2, you'll see in brackets the size of the moon. The apparent size is going to be 8.8 meters, which is pretty big. And here on the map, you have the size of the moon, so you can compare it to the subject. In this case, as you see, the moon is going to be as big as the lighthouse. Can't wait. So planning is key to get the shot you want. And if you wish to learn how to plan your eclipse shot, watch this video. On the eclipse date, September 7th, arrive at the shooting spot at least 1 hour before the eclipse begins. And set up everything, your tripod, your camera, on the shooting spot. This is the red beam position in PhotoPills. And make sure that everything is stable. Use the PhotoPills augmented reality views to visualize the eclipse position in the sky, so you double check that you are at the right shooting spot. Now set the focal length you wish to use to get the framing you want, to get the photo you want. For example, a 500 mil. If your goal is to photograph only the faces of the eclipse without foreground, then meet the light on the surface of the moon before the eclipse begins. Set the aperture to f/8 to get the deep, nice depth of field, but get ready to open the diaphragm to f/5.6, for example, to allow more light in the sensor, with the goal of keeping the shutter speed under 1 second. Because you want to avoid the motion blur on the moon due to the rotation of Earth. Set the ISO to 100, but again, be ready to push the ISO up to 400, to 800, to allow more light to the system if you need it. But again, get ready to push the ISO up to 400, to 800, to get the exposure right. This, of course, will depend on the natural light you'll have at the time of the shooting. Now, set the shutter speed that gives you the right exposure on the moon. For example, during the phase of the partial lunar eclipse, set a base shutter speed of 1 over 125 seconds. And bracket the exposure to make sure that you get the exposure right, at least in one photo. Usually, a one-stop bracketing of 3 photos will do the job. As the eclipse progresses, and you're entering into totality, you'll need to increase the exposure to get detail in the shadows. So during totality, you'll need to use a slower shutter speed, like 0.5 seconds. And again, bracket. But remember, don't go over 1 second, if you can. Now, make focus on the moon. And if you're photographing the eclipse aligned with an interesting subject, make focus on your subject. Then take a test shot and make sure that the moon, or both the moon and your subject, are in focus. There is a really easy way in PhotoPills to figure out the camera settings you need to use to get both in focus, the moon and your subject, and you have this method in this video. Watch it. And last but not least, check that the exposure is right. Check that you're capturing detail both in the highlights and in the shadows. And if something is wrong, make the necessary adjustments in the exposure or in the focusing. And if you wish to keep learning, if you wish to learn how to plan and photograph a total lunar eclipse, I invite you to download and study well our super detailed lunar eclipse photography guide, and I'll leave a link to the guide in the description of this video and in the first comment below. Download it. And as always, if you like this video, give me a like, subscribe, and I'll see you next Wednesday in another video. And remember that you had power to imagine, plan and shoot legendary photos. Bye.